Got some real niggas in this bitch. Real niggas, they gon' ride it in.
The renegade, the renegade.
Who you do it for? I do it for the streets, the people, the haters, we need them. The ones who done been doubted and turned them folks in believers. For the struggle, the hustle, my mama, I love ya. You taught me how to get it, I got this shit from the muscle. From the block, the gutter, the bottom, we thugging. I did this shit for y'all and I guarantee that they love it. Who you do it for? Now who you do it for? Yeah. If I die tonight, just lace me in Versace gear. I pray for all them pussies in they hating spirit. Hope my casket run me 80 to 100,000.
Boom. As we turn it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, we are located a couple miles west of the Colorado State Capitol building here in downtown Denver. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Austin Bats and the Denver Broncos. And hello again, everyone. Brandon Godden alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, we look at this Bronco team. They come in playing some decent football, 5-3 in their last 8 games. Meanwhile, for our visiting Austin ball club, they're hitting their stride of late. Winners of 3.
Here we go.
They're on the counter now on first down. Got some real estate inside the 30. And touchdown! A great play there. His 9th touchdown of the season. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. With these Thursday night games, sometimes you get those quick turnarounds. You wonder how. And it's good to make it 7-0. So this drive spans 7 plays. And a long run there in the end to top it off. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. They find some open field here. And he will score. Beckham. 99 yards. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. Well, there you go. They gave up a score to start the game, and as quick as they could get it back, they did on the return.
And people talk about this all the time, whether you're coaching it, whether you're trying to work on it, whether you're just trying to put in the minds of your players. Attack back as fast as you can after giving up a score. No quicker way than on a kick return.
And he'll give it here to his running back.
Gaps and holes, he's found his way through them for 2 touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet.
That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner. But it is something to build on. They did get the win, didn't they?
And oh, his first carry, he loses the football.
Jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground. Whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you...
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Throwing back across his body. Picked off by Jaleel Ladai. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
Oh, timing is everything. That football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
out. Now comes the offense back onto the field. Second and goal as the offense looks to try to punch it in. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Just a four-play drive then. Plenty of scoring here already. Charles and I back to Denver after this.
NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. It's Bronco football to begin quarter number. And I think he was thinking first down before he caught that football.
Yeah, got to catch it first, because if you don't catch it, there's no chance of picking up a first down.
And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. And coming out now, the Broncos. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to... And they'll try the ground game. It's into the end zone. Touchdown. It's 28-7. That time a 9-play drive, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you on down to our studios in Orlando, where standing by is Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, back to you and Charles in a bit. But first, let's get you caught up on all the highlights from the first half. The Broncos now for 2 straight weeks are having trouble throwing the football. The bats have done enough on that end to disrupt the flow, and that's played into it as well. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Batch later on the drive. He'll cut it off the left side this time. He caps off the 7-play drive with a score. They go up by 1. Tucker set up to kick it away. The return will start from the 49. And nobody can stop him on this long touchdown. We're tied back up at 7. Batch with the ball midway through the first. This run stays up the middle here, and this 5-play drive goes for a touchdown. That puts them up by a touchdown. And to late in the first, here the defense will come up with the pick. Bats will come away with the football. After the INT, offense comes out now. This one will go off the left side, and a quick 3-play drive ends with the score. That puts them up by 2 touchdowns. First and 10, coverage breaks down on the deep pass. And he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 18-yard line. Continuing on the drive, 1 play coming up here, and he capped off the long drive with the TD.
And that'll increase their lead.
There are more people there to get him down.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Broncos cut into that lead. Like he'll throw here. And it's caught. And that'll increase their lead to 28. So that drive
for get the ball. He has a knack for finding his.
his way over.
Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. A drive there of just four plays. And the capper that put it in the end zone, a run of 8 yards. Another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for our visitors, the win will move them to 7-2 now on the year. And they'll get a few extra days to savor this one before they take on the Oakland Raiders. Meanwhile, for the Broncos, they'll lose an important one here as that drops them to 5-4 on the season. And they'll try again next week at home against New England. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com.
Oh my. Yeah.
Beats round to life. A Tribe Called Weezy.
What the fuck, man?
I'ma live my life, have my fun, act like I don't give a fuck. Live my life, have my fun, smoke like I don't give a fuck. Live my life, have my fun, fuck that shit, you only get one. Fuck that shit, I gotta sip something, I got a bitch leaving, I got a bitch coming. Hey, I'm getting more pop on my skateboard. Niggas don't want me to pop like a bungee cord. I got my red bone head gone. That Bugatti go skirt, got the legs showing.